There are two very commonly picked bomb sites in that armory upstairs and that ventilation right underneath. Although we have seen a little bit of variation played on border in previous seasons, we have not really seen that shown through in this particular season. Penta small office, but if there is, Fabian's going to have a good chance at holding this.
Now, it looks as though Yuke is going to be holding
there
down.
There it is.
Yep, you see the mirror window there. It's going to be holding down the fort here right on the other side of a wall. Pengu wants to go out and make this peek. He knows he's got one chance because there's glass on the other side. One shot goes wrong, and Pengu will be down. Ness is going to be underneath inside of the servers, looking to shoot up inside of the floor of lockers as well as that middle office.
Yeah, if he can get a good Ash Charge right underneath Fabian there, that will basically nullify all the defense that Penta has set up here.
Now, it looks as though Yuke has been injured, almost being shocked to death there inside of the barbed wire. Diffuser is going down right now, however, it gets stopped and thwarted by Pengu. Now we're going to have right here a 3-on-4 at the moment, as one will take down Fabian in return. Yuke is still injured, so a 3-on-2 at the moment, unless they're going to get him back up and running. 30 seconds remain. Ness trying to come around for the flank around. He's coming inside of Fountain, inside of B, sees it's all clear, comes around. KS sees the shots, but he misses, and that's going to be Ness coming around as Pengu gets one, but Ness gets the last two members of Penta, and we are going to see round number one go directly in the hands of Black Dragon. Rotating around here inside of the armory locker room. Zig, though, drops Eunice down for the count. That's Hibana.
This is a nice flank from Zig here, and unfortunately, Penta not really covering all their bases here. They will trade it back onto Zig. However, he should not have been allowed to get the first kill in the at all, and in fact, get himself into CCTV, period.
Pengu's going to be the one just popping a couple shots through that middle door into the window, forcing Diogo to try to rotate around, and he does, but he does fail as KS goes around for the shock. That's his second kill of the round. 35 seconds remains. Ness going to be inside of the middle office here, right by one. They're going to go together. Now a couple pop shots go towards Fabian, but misses target. Diffuser is going to get planted, and he will be popped off. Pengu inside of that middle hallway. Now one's going to try to rotate around undetected for the time being. There is a drone, though, inside of the break room. He might get spotted out here if we have the Hibana that's actually on the drone. One, however, is going to move into the break room. We don't see Penta rotating around just yet, but they've already held onto the angles right there, and Pengu with the pistol shot onto one. We're going to have this go to 1-1 right now.
Mira, and now BD is kind of sort of at a loss how they're going to take this site. They haven't been able to maintain or establish upstairs control, and Yuck instead has just waltzed into the bomb site.
And with that, we are going to have Goga drop down Zig, but Dioig and Yuke, are he going to drop down Eunice and Pengu? KS picks up one kill of his own onto Yuke, though. That's the glass that's been killed off. A 3-on-3 still going to go with 30 seconds left to go. Diffusers in the hands of one. Now, last seen, one was out by Tellers. Has he rotated around? He is going in for the plant inside of the site at the moment. Nesk has control of the top floor. The C4 goes tossing, and that will drop Diffuser. It has not been planted. Fabian is also going to be injured in the process. We are going to have one drop from the middle offices here. That's going to be Nesk. He gets a one kill. He's going to go for the other one here by KS. Can he get it? No, he cannot. It's going to be a trade here. Nesk is going to get finished off by KS. It's going to be Dioigoi. He's here coming to the offices. Plant is going to go down. No utility left on him, so he will have to take this gunfight in a 1-on-3. This is all going to come down to pre-fire placements when he sees targets or even before he sees them. So Dioigoi is going to go for the shots there onto Fabian momentarily. He's got plenty of time still to get this clutch, but it's not going to be easy. Hard right on the doorway is going to be the glass. That's Fabian. Out to the left side is going to be Pengu. Looks as though Fabian will not get his shot. No, he will get the shot there onto Dioigoi, and we will have Penta secure round number 4.
Dragons be able to deal with this mirror window, or is it going to cause them problems?
No, it is. Right now, not going to be in favor of Pengu. He actually hopped on over, exposed himself for the time being. I didn't think he was going to get a kill here, but he actually did pick up that kill into Zig. Gas grenade got tossed on out. Diffuser was also fallen outside of that west balcony, outside of the west wall into A. He has taken quite a bit of damage, though, just like Fabian. They are the only two defenders right now that are directly holding down the A site. Fabian inside of the middle office, Pengu back by middle lockers. We will see how this unfolds in the next 55 seconds. We've got members of BD outside on the west balcony. That's Thatcher behind Yuke, and they're gonna work their way forward. Another gas grenade gonna get tossed on out. That's the last one from Pengu. And it looks like though he will be injured. Not quite sure from where, maybe a pre-fire as he spun around the corner, and Ness will pick up that kill into Eunice. So right now you're holding with three members down onto the site as Pengu is injured in the process. 4-on-2 at the moment, 4-on-3, 3-on-3 with KS dropping the shot down onto Yuke. C4 gets tossed on out, does not do the damage it needs to, and that's gonna allow Dioigoi to move forward, but he will get taken out by KS. He's down for the count. One, and we've got one, and who else here? Ness is gonna be the last man alive in a 1-on-2. with KS finishing off the shot into one. Penta is now having two members left alive. You gotta look inside of the middle. Off as he goes in, the crossfire happens and Nesk will go down. Penta's gonna secure this. 4-1 at the moment. We are now one map away, 1 point away from match. On the right side of it and plant underneath him. You've got cover from underneath. KS is gonna be getting that shot down onto Yuke. This is looking like it's gonna be a Penta map.
Black Dragons is going to have to do something spectacular on this retake in a 3-5 situation. There is still that mirror window in the small office, so there's still the possibility they're going to be able to maintain this round, but it's going to be tricky to say the least.
Mm-hmm. Now, Pengu does have the diffuser. He's going to be placing it down at the moment.
Here
C4 is going to get tossed on out and actually miss its target.
So there's that underneath pressure coming up to open up that mirror window, and that's going to signify the attack here for Penta.
Yep, and now one knows exactly what's happening here. The plant's gonna go down by Pengu, and instead of someone being behind him as he does it, he's gonna use all that as cover and the back of his shield. Fabian drops the one shot onto one, and now we've got a 5-on-2 at the moment. That is Goga that has been injured and taken out for the count. A 2-on-4 is gonna persist. Diffuser has been down, and this means this is gonna be a Penta map. Zig, last man alive here, as he is being piddled with bullets from underneath. Nade's gonna come, force him back off site, and now he's got about 40 health and 4 members of Penta to deal with. This is not gonna bid well for him, and Zig will go down by the hipfire from Pengu. Map number 1 goes to Penta Sports.
A through and through Penta map here on border. A great attack there coming in through the A bomb site wall. And they did deal with every single roadblock that Black Dragon set up to delay that attack coming out from Penta, but it just wasn't enough. I especially like the way that they used Monty there to go ahead and force the issue with Black Dragons, not wasting any time whatsoever. Time and time again, we see a team, they're going to come up to that A bomb site wall, they're going to see a mirror next to the doorway, and they're going to be like, okay, well, what do we do about the mirror?
What do we do?
What do we do about the mirror? What do we do about the mirror? And Penta just had the response for it. They had that Montaigne ready and primed. Let's just, shove him in the doorway. Then they can't do anything with the mirror.